write Koer, K-O-E-R, for MDR Crew. I'm originally from San Diego, and I got into this through skateboarding, mostly skateboarding and hip-hop. You know, it was in the 90s. Skating and graffiti kind of went hand in hand with that, and I'd see it in movies. You know, the internet wasn't around like it is today, so you just kind of had to see little bits of it on TV or underground VHS tapes that would be passed around through friends. So someone gave me a VHS tape called Videograph, and it had been passed around for years, and it showed real graffiti writers really bombing and really going out, and I was hooked, you know. I've been painting graffiti. I think I caught my first tags in 97. So since I was in middle school, I was just skate around with my friends and catch tags on stuff and didn't take it too seriously, but I started taking it real seriously about 2000. Right when I met my stepson's mother, she told me she had a son who was into skating, and him and his friends were kind of starting to get into graffiti. Same age I was too, you know? And as we got to know each other more and you know, I'd go out with him while he skated, and then I'd take him painting and show him, tell him what to do, what not to do. You know, when I first came around, he was like, they were young and dumb. They were like tagging in their neighborhood, tagging on their house, on the fence outside and stuff. To try to school them on, like, you know, ways to stay out of trouble, because I've been through all that when I was their age, you know. If you get into this shit, man, be careful. A lot of bigger cities have graffiti detectives, where that's their whole job, is to track down graffiti writers, build cases on them, and eventually arrest them and put a big case on them. So I've been sent to jail twice for this. For, you know, I've done a year in jail for this. I got sentenced to 2 years a different time. Someone had told on me a long time ago. This was 20 years ago. So it alerted the detectives who had been looking for me for a couple of years. And within a week, they had my phones tapped. They had surveillance driving around, following me at night. They sent undercover cops to an art show I had, and they sent the SWAT team to the house, and they kicked in the door. At the same time, in another town, they were kicking in the door of my co-defendant, my painting partner. We got brought in, we did interrogation, just like you see in the movies, you know? When I tell people in jail that happened to me for graffiti, almost no one would believe me. Waking up in bed with guns drawn on you, brought out in cuffs with the news there and stuff. But if you damage enough shit, they'll come and get you. They want to put restitution on you, right? They want you to pay it back. They want you to do jail time, and they want to make a statement. So be careful what you write on. You know, that's all I'd say to people. Just be aware that it can come back to bite you in the ass, and, you know, keep your identity safe.
DJ, represent O2M and FMR Crew. Shout out Friends Team, by the way. I want to say I've been, like, really riding with paint and shit pretty hard for maybe like the past 3 years, 4 years, but I've been doing it for like 6 or 5 so far. About this scene though, is like, this scene is so unique from like everywhere else, I would say, for real. It's a Humboldt scene, so a lot of the spots here are more on some shit where it's an old shed just somewhere in the forest, and you gotta like really know and how to get there. Like, it's more of a journey, and like every time I go out, it's something special because you learn so much more about where you're from, and you really start to learn every fucking like corner and crack and spot, just cause like you get this entire new lookout when you start riding on shit, cause that's all you ever want to do. some of the sweetest people I ever really fucking met here are writers. Big shout out Core MDR. I did a lot of missions with him and he really brought me up, teaching me away a lot of this shit. It's just, you can, it's like skateboarding, you know? You ain't judged, all y'all doing are just going out and doing the same thing, throwing letters down, fucking just, you're artists, really just doing art for free, but like, it's fucking an addiction. I got hooked so fucking fast, and I bet everyone else who really loves this shit could say the same. It never gets fucking old. You really just want to like show out, really show people what the fuck you're doing and what you're capable of. You want to like for real be on some shit where it's not just one. It's just a hundred. You just want to keep going and going and going.
Yep.
Yeah.
This is how we do it. You feel me? Why we do that shit, yeah, bro. You feel that?
Yeah.
Fuck, bro, that's why you do that shit. Motherfucking adrenaline rush. Shit, bro, it's different, for real.
Pokey repping NWOK out here, Humboldt County. I've been doing this for probably about 5 years, something like that. I love graffiti. I always thought it was super cool, but I didn't know shit about it. This fool right here taught me how to paint. This is my mentor right here.
So homies, Mason, No Way Out crew dog from San Diego. Just killing shit dog, trying to do the most with this graph shit, you know?
Homie came up here, I met him through a mutual friend. He came from San Diego and I like met him, immediately liked his stuff, what he was doing.
We started out as friends, it wasn't really like graph or anything. It was just basically like, I was fucking around and he fucking just tagged along.
Homie fucking put me on, he taught me what's what with the cans and how to work it. And so I started putting in work and trying to get a little better, get my can control down and whatnot.
Yeah, this fool's fucking been putting in mad work for sure. He's progressed a lot.
My style kind of started off, I like the classic like New York, like bubble letter kind of shit. And then this fool showed me like a more aggressive, like West Coast style that I was like really, really liking, really digging. And I started to catch inspo from that.
I don't really have very much to say about my style besides it just comes out how it is, you know?
This fool's humble as shit. He's just fucking crushing it. He's got super mean, aggressive letters. Shit's fucking sharp, crazy.
He's just being nice, dog. He's just being nice.
I got real entrenched in the community over this last year, especially. It's a real tight-knit community. It's already a small area, so like a lot of people know a lot of other people. There's a lot of talent out here too. There's some fools who are from out of the area who are fucking legends in other regions, like Lobo, fucking KBC, homie, fucking Demise too. Like out here we're really standing on the shoulders of giants when it comes to painting. Like there's a lot to fucking try to catch up to, you know, try to be getting better at and trying to fucking work towards that level of like fucking can control and all the technique that they got, you know. But it's like I said, it's real close-knit. Most people know who other people are, but also in turn that creates a lot of like silly ass beef where people are just like fucking drama queens, you know, fucking divas. But I mean, I don't know. I'm out here, I try to fucking catch a tag, catch a fucking piece or whatever, and I wanna take a picture of it, and that's all I care about is getting a flick. Cause it's like I said, everything gets disc gone over a buff, so it's like.
I met my girlfriend through graffiti up here. I met her through Instagram and we just started kicking it and started painting and then it just went from there, you know?
It was
super cool.
It was wild because I remember when they first started kicking it and it was funny because he was hitting up like everybody to paint, like everybody fucking yeah. Help. He was like, hey, let's go paint. And everybody would flake on him and she was the only one who was like, yeah, let's go paint. And yeah. Would actually like come and kick it, so.
It's dope to have somebody that to share like that, you know what I mean? To do the same thing. It's fucking sick, bro. I love it. Even like with the home, like, that shit's fun. I like to chill at a spot too, like bombing. Like you said, bombing and shit's cool, but it's like also super sick to like just post up and fucking just fucking have a good fucking time, fucking drink some brew,
yeah,
fucking bump some music, dog, and have a good time. It's all really what it's about, you know? Yeah.
I go fucking crazy without graph, man. Like, I get too inside, I get in my own head, it's just, there's something therapeutic about just like going out and not having any permission, going and being like, fuck it, like I wanna fucking paint a piece.
It's an escape, you know, it helps out a lot mentally, for sure. It's just like any other hobby, you know? It's like a sense of accomplishment, like once you hit a spot, you know?
It gives you this feeling of permanence and impermanence. You know, everything is destined to get dissed, gone over, buffed. It doesn't matter what you put up, but like, you're saying I'm here. Like, I'm fucking here and I exist. And that shit feels really good.